It's one of the most anticipated movies of the year.
I lifted up and I looked down. Mom was in one room, you were in another room yelling at God.
Heaven is for real on today's 700 Club Interactive.
On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to pray for each other and explore topics that matter to you. Watch what God is doing in the world today.
Well, good morning and welcome to the show. His story spent weeks on the New York Times bestseller list. Now it's a major motion picture starring Greg Kinnear, and he's done all of this before his 15th birthday. Here's the amazing story of Colton Burpo and why he believes heaven is for real.
How old are you today?
3.
And what is your name? And where do you live?
In Nebraska.
Who's your mommy?
Sonia.
Who's your daddy?
Daddy Burpo.
Who's your sister?
Cassie.
That was 10 years ago. Looking at Colton now, you would have never guessed that he almost died in 2003. His father, Todd, tells about Colton's near-death experience in the book, Heaven is for Real.
And he started throwing up into the toilet, you know, and at first we're like, okay, he's got the stomach flu, because the doctor said it was going around.
Colton's condition only got worse as days passed. His doctor discovered his appendix had burst, and infection was spreading in his body. Time was running out.
Then we knew we were in bad shape when they said, well, you need to come out to the hallway. They separated us from everyone else, and then someone came to us and started talking to us that we got to have surgery on your kid.
It was tough. Seeing your boy be lifeless when he was a very vibrant child.
And it was at that moment that we were looking at each other. I remember my wife holding Colton in that hallway, just us. He's not even moving. We went to the surgery prep area, and I remember them hauling him away and him just yelling at me, Daddy, don't let him take me, Daddy, don't let him take me. And I went back to the pre-op room where we had left some stuff, and I was finally alone, shut the door, and I just broke down and I was mad at God. I just frustrated, fed up. And I remember telling him, I said, God, after all I've done for you, and now you're gonna take my kid? This is how you treat your pastors.
And I was calling our prayer chain. I was calling anybody that would be on the other line to get Colton on the prayer chain because it was bad.
We were there in the waiting room for an hour and a half, maybe. Then I remember the nurse coming out. Is Colton's daddy out here? I'm like, yeah, well, Colton's in recovery and he's screaming for you. And I'm sitting there with him. And I remember my son in that room then looking up at me and goes, Dad, do you know I almost died? And my first thought was, maybe he overheard the nurse say that, or maybe they thought he was under anesthesia, you know, and he wasn't. But it wasn't till 4 months after we got out of the hospital that we finally listened to our son.
And that's where I got to see heaven. No, Jesus and some angels came and flew me up to heaven.
And I said, so Colton, what did Jesus look like?
I knew that the first person I saw was Jesus. He was wearing white robes with a purple sash, and he just came down nicely and gracefully.
Well, Dad, Jesus has markers. Dad, Jesus has markers. I didn't know what he meant, so I finally asked the right question. Colton, where are Jesus' markers? And he drops his toys down, and he stands up, and he just points, Dad, they were right here. He takes his fingers, points to the palms, then he bends over and touches the tops of his feet. And looks up to me, and that's where Jesus' markers were, Dad.
When I was in the throne room of God to start with, so I got to see what that looked like. I was upset because I didn't know what was happening. What God did is he used people or things that I liked to calm me down. From there on, I felt better.
Then one day we're traveling together, and he looks up at me and, Dad, you used to have a grandpa named Pop, didn't you? Like, yeah, he's really nice. Really, yeah, you used to play with him as a kid and fix, work with him on the farm and shoot stuff with him. And I'm like, yeah, how do you know that? Well, he told me.
A figure came up and he was Pop. He asked me, are you Todd's son? I said, yes. He said that he was his grandpa. So that's where I met him.
Yeah, Pop, I was very close to him. And he was my most significant male role model when I was a kid growing up. But he was killed in a car wreck before I turned 7.
I was busy paying bills again, because that's my job. And he came up and told me he had 2 sisters. Well, he had to say it several times before he finally got my attention. And finally, I put my stuff down and looked at him and says, what do you mean you have 2 sisters? No, I have 2 sisters. You had a baby die in your tummy. And I just looked at him like, well, how do you know you have 2 sisters? Well, she told me. And then he proceeded to describe her.
She looked like Cassie, but she had brown hair. And first time when she saw me, she just came up and hugged me.
We knew this was true because he said she kept hugging me. She wouldn't stop hugging me, Mom, and I didn't like that.
Well, I'm not really the hugging type.
I had miscarried the weekend of Father's Day weekend, which made it even rougher. And we thought we'd dealt with it. We gotten over, we accepted that the baby had died. But when he said he had 2 sisters, I think I was in shock first and then trying to realize, what is he telling me? And so I knew that he had seen her, and after he described her, and he said, she's just waiting for you guys to come to heaven.
You know, as we talked about heaven and he was telling me all these wonderful details, I just felt like I had to ask him, did he want to come back?
I knew that I was leaving heaven because Jesus came to me and said, Colton, you need to go back. Even though I didn't want to go back, he said that he was answering my dad's prayer.
I remember that prayer. That irreverent, that disrespectful, screaming at God prayer. I was like, he's answering that prayer?
Today, Colton is a healthy 13-year-old and shares his heavenly journey with boldness.
I learned that heaven is for real and you're gonna like it.
Recently, CBN's Wendy Griffith sat down with the Burpo family to find out what's happened since the release of the book and how the Hollywood adaptation of their story has changed their lives.
And joining us now is the Burpo family, Todd, his wife Sonia, and their son Colton. It's great to see you guys.
Thank you for having us,
Wendy. Thanks so much for coming back.
Thank you.
Well, okay, first a book, now a movie. How does it feel, Todd, to see your story having so much influence?
Well, it's good to see the response to it, because we originally took a risk saying, okay, if the peace and the hope that we found can do for others what it did for us, this is worth taking a risk. But to see it go so far and so broad, you sit back and you're like, God saw things we never saw, but we're so grateful for it, because we hear people all the time saying, this really helped, thank you, and so we're grateful for that.
Well, Sonia, thousands have been impacted by the book and the story and now the movie coming out. How has this changed your own lives?
Well, I think spiritually for us, it definitely, we believed in heaven before, but now we kind of have a better picture of what heaven is, and we're not home, but we're going home.
Well, tell us, Todd, how the book became a movie, and not just any movie. Greg Kinnear, one of my favorite actors, plays you, so it's a Hollywood all-star cast. How did the book become a movie?
Well, they actually approached me. You know, we never sought Hollywood. Hollywood sought us, and we just said no, no,
Who's
no.
Who's they? And they approached you.
Producers from production companies, many of them called my agent, called us, and it was the conversation I had with Joe Roth, Bishop T.D. Jakes, and Devon Franklin, where I felt like in that moment, I had the guarantee that they would be true to Colton's story. And until I had that confidence, going forward wasn't even an option for us. We were like, my last never was, I would never make a movie. And so I try to not you know, use that word anymore. But that was the thing that started. And if we didn't have that confidence, we wouldn't have pursued it. Now, years later, then, you know, Randal Wallace gets selected to be the director. And then he selects, I think more than anyone else probably, you know, Greg Kinnear to play me, and those are things you don't know at the beginning when you make these decisions. But God showed me at the very beginning, he was like, I'm gonna show you that I'm bigger than Hollywood. Mm. And he's done that. At the end of the day, what you're gonna see in theaters today, you know, you're gonna sit there and go, wow. But God had to show himself in many, many, many steps. And I think Randal Wallace is probably one of the biggest ones, because To take a true life story and depict it like he did on film, yeah. Greg Kinnear, the cast, everyone, this is A-plus quality.
It's huge. Well, Colton, let's talk to you. I've seen the film, and the little guy who plays you is, first of all, the cutest thing I've ever seen in my life, and looks a lot like you. Of course, you're now almost 14?
I am 14.
Oh, 14 in how many months?
My birthday's next month.
Okay. Well, because your mom told me you like to be very exact. Okay. What did you think when you saw this movie?
Well, I think that a lot of people are going to find healing with it. I mean, everybody has a hurt. So I think that this film will just give them hope that there is something better.
Yeah. Now, the way they depicted heaven in the movie, of course, was very creative. We won't give it away, but what was your take on that, the way that...
Well, it's hard to depict something you've never seen or experienced before. So I think that even though they have never seen it or experienced it, that I thought they did a pretty good job, and they'll be able to show people, hey, this is a glimpse of heaven.
Yeah.
But of course, heaven is much much better than that.
Mm. Of course, you have seen it, and you've been there, and you were only 3, almost 4, when you took that trip to heaven. Do you still remember it and recall it as vividly now as you did then?
Yes, I can still remember my trip to heaven very vividly.
Mm. Wow, what a great memory. Well, Todd, what do you want people to take away from the movie Heaven is for Real?
Well, I think the movie is very honest. It shows a real family with real issues. They'll see that pastors are real people, too. Mm. But I think hopefully they'll see that Colton's not special, we're not special. What Jesus did for us, he wants to do for you, too. He wants to do the same thing for everyone. And if you would just let Jesus into your life and just let Jesus do for you what he wants to, it's a great thing. But that's what I hope they walk away from those theaters realizing, that we can experience what Colton did.
Mm. Sonia, let me ask you this. What was, when you're watching the movie, the most emotionally charged scene for you, or maybe there's more than one?
I think the whole movie's emotionally charged. As women, we're emotional beings, but and then seeing your family life played out is hard to watch. But I think the most emotionally charged is probably when Colton comes in and, you know, he announces he has 2 sisters. Miscarriage is a silent, quiet hurt that a lot of people go to the grave with, and we have now given a voice or a platform for people to talk about it and get some healing.
Of course, Colton was only 3. You had never told him that he had a sister that died in your womb. Of course, he was too young to understand what a miscarriage was, but he came and said that he met his sister in heaven.
And he thought he was just announcing to us some other news, matter of fact, hey, I have a sister, and he did not realize how emotionally charged his sentence was. Mm. And we thought he'd gotten over it, gotten healing, and he brought more healing to us by telling us about her. She's okay. And as mothers, we want to take care of our kids. We want to make sure they're okay. And what a better place than heaven to be taken care of.
Wow. Todd, let me ask you the same thing. What scene was the most emotional for you to watch?
Well, watching my son be wheeled away down to that surgery. Again, that was right preceded my yelling at God, you know, and I still remember that. Matter of fact, fortunately for us, we've talked about it. They're remodeling that hospital now. Mm-hmm. But as a pastor, I've avoided that hallway, and I've had to walk down it before. And to see that depicted, that's tough.
Yeah. That scene is hard to watch, but you're still pastoring.
Yes.
And, you know, in the movie, you go through, Greg Kinnear was playing you, he goes through a crisis of faith. Did that really happen?
Well, I think the biggest crisis for me was not about the reality of heaven, but what did I believe about near-death experiences?
Yeah.
That was a struggle for me, because I didn't know what I believed about that. Now, obviously, I had my son, and a 4-year-old can't fool you, and you realized it was true, and I had the backdrop of scripture to test against it. And obviously, I know my son saw what he saw, and he's not making anything up. But I've been amazed that God knew a child needed to talk about heaven, because his descriptions of heaven are now reaching people that us adults never could. And I think God knew that.
Well, the little actor who plays Colton is so believable.
He's awesome. You're going to see on screen the closest representation I could have ever imagined what I saw 11 years ago.
Wow. Well, that's the best endorsement that anyone could ask for. Yeah. Well, Todd, Sonia, Colton, it is a pleasure. Thank you so much for being here and sharing your thoughts with us.
Thank you.
Still ahead, you're going to meet the man who wrote Braveheart and directed Heaven is for Real after this.
I have a son who's extremely smart and sensitive. He went to heaven. I came back.
One true story has become a worldwide sensation.
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Now, Heaven is for Real is a profoundly beautiful movie.
They don't believe me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
That will help many to believe.
Is heaven a hope or as real as the earth and sky?
A perfect family film. Heaven is for Real. Rated PG.
Nicht so schlapp! Los, weiter, Jule! Geh weiter! Der nächste.
Links.
Duschen.
Duschen.
Lass mich. Duschen.
Duschen.
Nur ein Jude.
Geh weiter.
Before the break, I had the opportunity to sit down with the Burpo family, the subjects of a new major motion picture, Heaven is for Real. And joining me now is the movie's director, Randal Wallace. Randall, welcome to the show.
Oh, so great to be with
great
you.
Great to be you. With you. Now, you read the book, and then did you just decide this has to be a movie? How did this happen?
Well, I read the book, and I really fell in love with the Burpo family. I saw such a real story in them, people who weren't trying to manufacture something, but someone for whom a miracle had happened, a completely real kind of miracle. You know, what happens when you're a parent and you go through this experience of nearly losing your child, an unthinkable thing to me. And then he starts to talk about what heaven is like. It's like everything you would want to believe, and then can you really accept that? And what are its implications? It's not like they thought, how do we manufacture a story? It's like suddenly we're in the grip of God. And that's a great tale anytime, anywhere.
Well, was that a challenge? How do you depict heaven? I mean, even as a very great movie maker as you are, I mean, how do you depict something that nobody has really seen?
That was the big scary part. Because in most movies, what you end up with is like, Morgan Freeman in white pajamas and and everything, and which I love the movie in which that
Bruce
appeared.
Almighty, yeah.
I love that movie. It's made by a great friend of mine. And I understand why you do that, because heaven is so majestic. There's always been a prohibition against trying to depict the face of God out of the sacredness, and it's too holy. But this boy, Colton Burpo, came back saying, this is what heaven is like. And that was what was so gripping to me. And I wanted to let the audience see that, experience that. And the closest that I knew how to come was inspired by the Lord's Prayer, on earth as it is in heaven. Mm-hmm. And the thought that, as C.S. Lewis said, God is a great artist, and God's handiwork is evident to us here in this world at its most beautiful, at its unspoiled. Mm-hmm. So we didn't try to create fantasy elements for heaven. We tried to use the most beautiful elements of the earth to say, this must be what heaven is like.
Right. Well, there have been some early screenings, and I fortunately had the opportunity to see it. What are some of the reactions that you're getting from people?
Well, did it ruin your mascara? Because it's making a lot of people
yes,
emotional.
Yes, it did, actually. There's some very emotional scenes.
And it is for me, too. In screenings now, and I've seen the movie, you know, dozens and dozens of times, and it still moves me. What has really been striking to me is that people of faith, people who see themselves as having a spiritual discipline and practicing, they really love this movie. Mm. What surprised me, but is something that we all wanted, I know the Burpos wanted it and I sure wanted it too, is that the movie would say to people who see themselves as outside the faith,
right,
that God loves them, that God is always reaching out. And that the audiences that have come in, we tested it for audiences who identified themselves as having no faith at all. Hmm. And their emotional reaction has been as great as the faith-based audience. They're less likely to want to talk about it because they're afraid of sounding religious.
Yeah.
But they love the movie. And it's a movie that reaches across boundaries. I love to say God's love jumps all the fences.
It sure does. Great. Well said. Well, you got Greg Kinnear, one of my favorite actors, to play Todd Burpo, and it is an all-star cast. Was that difficult? Because this is a faith-based movie, and Hollywood can sometimes have some issues with that. Did the actors, did Kinnear and the others have any problem knowing this is a very evangelical, faith-based movie?
I'll tell you, writing, directing, acting, what we're doing, what you do, it's an act of faith. Mm-hmm. You've got to have the courage to face whatever somebody, and if you live your life along the lines of, I'm going to let myself be measured by what other people think of me, then you've lost your soul. Yeah. And in some ways, the fundamental spiritual issue is to say, God loves me, that's enough. If God loves me, then nothing else will matter because everything else will be right. And those actors that I asked, all of the actors that I wanted said yes immediately.
Mm. Wow.
And I can only attribute that to something much greater than me working.
Well, you have written, produced, and directed some of Hollywood's biggest hits, Braveheart, probably everyone's favorite movie. I know it's one of my favorite movies. How have you seen God use you in the secular world of movie making?
I think the biggest thing for me is that God's plans are way greater than our plans are. One of my early teachers in the seminary said, if you want to make God laugh, just tell God your plans. I didn't go to Hollywood planning to be a director at all. It was never my ambition.
Really? Why'd you go? To be an actor?
I wanted to be a songwriter.
Oh.
And I was so good at it that no one ever listened to my songs. No one ever wanted to hear me sing.
But then you end up making Braveheart, working with Mel Gibson, and Pearl Harbor, and the list goes on. And what do you hope, Randall, what do you hope people are going to take away from Heaven is for Real?
I want people to have the experience in the movie of having had a glimpse of heaven themselves. Mm. And when they go, they'll have a sense of joy and wonder and a sense of mystery. But, you know, so much that we talk about when you have a crisis of faith, when we say that,
right,
it generally means that something terrible has happened to you.
Right.
But in fact, the real challenge is to believe the best possible things are true. That God loves you, that where babies come from is where we go when we take our last breaths here. Mm. If we can believe that, then life is eternal and eternally wonderful.
That is profound, and I seriously wish we had more time. Randal Wallace, thanks so much for spending some time with us today. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
The movie Heaven is for Real opens on April 16th in theaters nationwide. And a special movie edition of the book is available nationwide. Coming up, Gordon will be back with more 700 Club Interactive right after this.
About the hospital. Does that scare you?
No, that's where the angels sang to me.
The angels sang to you?
Nervous about tackling the afterlife and what happens when you die?
Between nervous and sheer terror.
In heaven, this little girl came up to me. She told me she died in your tummy.
It tells you a story, an honest story, and I thought he did an amazing job in doing that.
Heaven is for Real on the 700 Club next.
I have a son who's extremely smart and sensitive. He went to heaven. I came back.
One true story has become a worldwide sensation.
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Now, Heaven is for Real is a profoundly beautiful movie.
They don't believe me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
That will help many to believe.
Is heaven a hope or as real as the earth and sky?
A perfect family film. Heaven is for Real. Rated PG.
CBN TV on CBN.com. All the video you love in one easy to use location.
CBN's animated series is broadcasting around the world. And recently, a little girl in the Philippines watched one of the latest episodes of Superbook. And she went from disobedient to helpful overnight.
Yasmin loves playing school with her little brothers. She likes being the teacher.
When I grow up, I want to become a math teacher.
But Yasmin struggled at home, doing her chores and obeying her parents.
I grumble sometimes because it seems like I have more jobs than my brother.
Then one Sunday, Yasmin saw an episode of CBN's animated series, Superbook.
Superbook is amazing. I like the characters and enjoy the story a lot.
Yasmin and her brothers watched Superbook on TV every time it came on. When they saw the episode called The Test, she was moved by what Chris did for a sick boy.
When he heard that a sick boy in a hospital wanted a video game like Chris had, Chris decided to give it to the sick boy. I learned the value of giving and started sharing more with my brothers.
Yasmin's mom noticed the change.
She became more obedient and helpful after she saw Superbook. Now, she sweeps the floor and washes the dishes without being asked. It's been a big change.
One day, Yasmin invited her neighbors to watch Superbook. After the show, Yasmin, with help from her dad, held a Superbook class where she helped her friends learn more about God.
I enjoyed watching the old version of Superbook as a kid. I'm happy now that Superbook is being a big influence on my children.
Superbook is my favorite program now because it teaches us a lot of great lessons from the Bible.
We're taking the stories of the Bible to children around the world. And if you want to be a part of it, if you want to be a part of seeing Superbook broadcast in over 42 languages, all you have to do is join the Superbook DVD Club. How much is it? It's just $25, and every 4 to 6 weeks, we'll send you the latest copy of the latest edition of Superbook. You'll get not just one copy for your gift of $25, you'll get three. So if you want to be part of the club, every 4 to 6 weeks, we'll charge your credit card, debit card, $25, ship you out three copies of the latest episode so you can be a part of distributing the stories of the Bible to your family, to your church, to the children in your neighborhood. You can be a part of getting the word out, getting them to know the stories of the Bible. So if that's you, call us, 888-777-1999. And if you want to get caught up on past episodes, all you have to do is go to cbn.com. There's a place there where you can designate which episodes you want to get. And again, it's for a gift of $25 or more. Well, that's all the time we have. We leave you this word from Psalm 8, verse 2. Out of the mouth of babes and nursing infants, you have ordained strength because of your enemies, that you may silence the enemy and the avenger. realize that it's out of the mouth of babes that God ordains strength. Why? Because it silences the enemy. God bless you. We'll see you again.